Dear professional friends, today in this video, I am going to discuss about the topic delay in justice, denial of justice, NCLT cases where judgment is reserved and final judgment is delayed. There are lot of cases where judgment has been reserved by NCLT and the final judgment is not yet delivered even after a month or 2 months or 3 months. So this video is going to discuss about the issues pertaining to this impediment. Every backlog of cases and delays in the Indian judicial system are once again the topic of much discussion, with everything from government closeness, litigiousness to judicial activism being blamed for 35 million cases pending in the courts at all levels throughout India. A recent survey of litigants showed that more than 60% of the respondents believed that the delay in their own cases was due to judge not passing orders quickly enough. In the statistical data given here, we can come to understand the following information. About 12% of the cases, judgments were delivered even after 120 days after judgment has been reserved by the court. So in 12% of the case where judgment has been delayed more than 120 days even after the judgment has been reserved. In civil cases, there is higher incidence of judgment being delayed for more than 120 days after judgment is being reserved by the civil court or criminal court or NCLT or Supreme Court or High Court. So in 9 cases, the judgment was delivered more than 1 year after being reserved, within the maximum time taken being 565 days. The list which I have enclosed in this video speaks about the various cases. Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation, the delay is more than 566 days after judgment is being reserved. In Commissioner of Central Excise, Goa, judgment is delayed, final judgment is delayed more than 510 days. In ILFS case, 484 days. In Ramesh Chandra case, 442 days. In Narayan and Laxman Patil case, 422 days. Avenue Supermarket, it is 415 days. Chebrolu Enterprises, 414 days. And Rambal case, 385 days, and Rajasthan Road Transport Corporation, 378 days. In 9 cases, judgment was delayed more than 1 year after being reserved, with the maximum time taken being 566 days, which is 1.5 years. In deposit insurance case, it took nearly 1.5 years for the court for delivering the final judgment after receiving the order. When a case is heard in depth and the arguments are advanced by both the parties, more often than not, the judge reserves judgment to examine the arguments, do research and write the final judgment before delivering it in the open court. In the Code of Civil Procedure 1908, applicable to civil courts, states that judgment should be delivered within 30 days after being closed. No such time restriction is found in NCLT rules and regulations. This is the main drawback. In NCLT, there are a lot of cases which has been reserved and pending for final judgment. There is no clear instruction in the rules and regulation by which time the NCLT has to pass the final order. The need for a time limit for delivering the judgment is not just to avoid delay, but to also to prevent a miscarriage of justice. A judge who takes too long to deliver judgment after hearing arguments may have forgotten some of the arguments or remembered them incorrectly, to the detriment of the parties. Supreme Court in Anil Roy versus State of Bihar. For this reason, even though no procedural law prescribes so, the Supreme Court has held in Anil Roy versus State of Bihar case that parties can file an application in the High Court seeking an early judgment if it is not delivered within 3 months of it being reserved. If it is not delivered more than 6 months after being reserved, parties have a right to have it reheard before a different bench of the High Court. There is no similar provision available in NCLT regulation, and NCLT regulation should be amended to introduce any delay more than 30 days for reserving the judgment. The parties can file in the NCLT seeking an early judgment. So currently there is no provision in the NCLT regulation to remind the judge to deliver the final judgment. So it is in the hands of the judge who has to deliver it, and he may take, if the more than 30 days is passed, even after that, if he not deciding it though in final order, then it will be a problem. So there is no provision in the NCLT, current NCLT rules and regulation. So it must be introduced that NCLT judgment should be passed within 30 days after the judgment is being reserved. In Subramaniam Swami 2G spectrum case, when Subramaniam Swami sought a direction from the court, seeing earlier Prime Minister Manmohan Singh to grant sanction to the prosecutor telecom minister A. Raja for corruption in the 2G spectrum case, the court took nearly 433 days to deliver the judgment after having reserved it. In the NAS Foundation case concerning the validity of Section 377 of the Indian Penal Code, the judgment was delivered 624 days later, or more than 20 months after being reserved. The relatively large number of cases where judgment delivered more than 90 days after being reserved by the bench suggests that the absence of a system to keep track of how long a case has been reserved for the judgment. So presently in the NCLT also there is no tracking system that how many judgment has been kept reserved and how long it has been kept reserved. There is no provision in the NCLT regulation as of now that within the what time the judgment have to be pronounced after being kept it as a reserved, as in the Code of Civil Procedure Code 1908 applicable to civil courts, which states that the judgment should be delivered within 30 days of the argument of the case once the argument has been closed. Similar provision has to be introduced in NCLT regulations and rules so that the judgment on reserved cases have to be delivered on time-bound basis as to avoid denial of justice due to delay of justice. Friends, I think this video will be more information to you, and if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel so that whenever you issue a new video in the future, it will reach you directly. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, Practicing Company Secretary.